Sage-grouse are the largest species of grouse in North America. They live in the western U.S. across about 11 western states, spanning 165 million acres of sagebrush habitat. The Forest Service is committed to the protection and conservation of greater sage-grouse on National Forest System lands. Sage-grouse are very charismatic. They're known for their mating displays. They puff up and try to entice the females. Sage-grouse are known for their lekking. A lek is a word that means both a place and an activity. It's actually a Scandinavian word that means to play. And so they come to a lek, or a breeding ground, where they display for the females. So the lek both refers to the location and the behavior when they come and they lek, or they are lekking, meaning that they're displaying for the females. So. Sage-grouse are a fascinating species, particularly in the spring when they come to these mating grounds. The males stage early in the morning, and as it gets light, they put on an impressive display trying to attract mates. They puff out their chests and make an odd thumping and popping sound. The females come in and quietly pick their way through the lek, looking at this male and then that. They're a lot of fun to watch. Spring is their mating season, so they start the mating ritual. The males will start showing up mid to late March on the lek, and then through the month of April. The sage-grouse lek is really the focal point, or the center of the sage-grouse life. Some are resident, meaning they're generally the same area year-round. Others are migratory, but they still return to the same leks year after year after year. So the sage-grouse is a really fascinating species, and it serves really as an icon or an umbrella species for the entire sagebrush ecosystem. There's over 350 different species that use the sagebrush ecosystem for all or at least parts of their life. So the sage-grouse, our concern over the sage-grouse is not only for that bird itself, but really for this vast and important sagebrush ecosystem in general. So sage-grouse rely on sagebrush year-round. It makes up the majority of their diet. From the sagebrush into kind of sagebrush openings and meadows where they really start focusing on forbs and insects. And then later in the fall and then through the winter, their diet is almost exclusively sagebrush. So this is a species that was aptly named the sage grouse, where it really focuses and relies on sagebrush.
You come to your back azimuth for your next one.
Yep. There's a lot of research that has been and is being conducted on sage grouse. In fact, it's probably the most studied of all the grouse species. The Forest Service is really using this scientific research to help us in our management of sage grouse. The Forest Service is doing a number of things to protect sage-grouse habitat, working collaboratively across states and more than 20 national forests and grasslands, making a difference for sage-grouse while meeting the multiple use mandate of the Forest Service. Reducing disturbance during critical times and in critical areas, reducing the threat of wildfire, controlling invasive weed species, and using sustainable rangeland management techniques. The Forest Service is taking an active role with our many partners in this unprecedented effort to conserve the sagebrush ecosystem for sage grouse and the other species that rely on this unique habitat, now and into the future.